From uncontrollable movement to unwanted noises, symptoms of Tourette syndrome are hard to hide. But Australians who live with the neurological condition want to remove its stigma and are turning to technology to raise awareness. Madeline Slattery explains.
For brothers Fergal and Albie, living with Tourette's can be a daily battle.
I have one where I go, and that one, like where I scrunch up my face and go cross-eyed, and I have to like move my head like that.
And the 12-year-old's tics can be much more severe.
I was in this massive group of people, and out of nowhere, I just yell the F word, and they all look at me, and so I just run off.
Today, their classmates got to take a walk in their shoes.
Walk the length of the cricket pitch while clicking your heels every fourth step.
Following activities in a new awareness app called TAC’TICS, which emulate what it's like to have a tic.
This whole school knows about Tourette's now, so they won't really judge me and Fergal.
There's many misconceptions of the neurological condition, including assumptions patients all swear. It's this kind of stigma they want to stamp out.
The other stigma I think about people with Tourette's is that it's behavioural, that we can stop if we want to. It's not easy to suppress tics.
More than 45,000 children in Australia have Tourette's syndrome, so it's not as rare as people may think. Despite this, one in four people have never heard of the condition.
Federal MP Chris Crowther only revealed he had it once his parliamentary career began, inspiring young people who may lack confidence.
It's so important to try and prevent bullying, particularly amongst children. If people are aware of it and they know someone has it, then they're less likely to bully them because of their habits.
Madeline Slattery,